All right. So look, this video is basically a quick hit, kind of a lesson on a song called Tequila, 1958 number one kind of pop R&B, Latin-tinged R&B song called Tequila. 1958, the year I was born. I would not have paid much attention to this cut at that point. I was listening to other music. So I'm using an A harp. And before I go any further, the version of the recording that you just heard, it's a brand new release by my duo, the Blues Doctors. I'm playing harp, I'm playing percussion, I'm going, hey! And my friend Alan Gross, the other Blues Doctors, playing guitar. We've got Brian W. Ward, he was our recording engineer, but he's also a great musician. He's playing stand-up bass, so it's the Blues Doctors, Tequila. Before I go any further, I'm going to ask you a favor. Would you please go to iTunes or Amazon MP3 or CD Baby, and will you search Blues Doctors Tequila, and will you send me a 99-cent, well, it's really, what do I get, 67 cents, something like that. Send me a tip. Buy the recording. Don't stream it. It's not going to be streamed. I'm categorically opposed to being ripped off by the music companies and getting 0.2 cents for every stream. So if you want the song, and I hope you do, please buy it. Now I'm going to show you how to play it. Basically, the song, the harmonic background of the song, is that we're moving between, it's in the key of E, I'm using an A harp, so I'm playing cross harp, it's moving between an E chord and a D chord, so it goes down a whole step. Dun, 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 dun. In a kind of interesting back and forth, which makes the soloing section a little bit tricky. I don't think I'm going to have time to talk about soloing. Hello. No, I'm not slapping you. I'm just trying to adjust. And then it goes to a diminished chord. Ba, ba, ba. And what I love is that it fits beautifully on these, what I call that magic dick note of the high end of the A harp, which is that bent 10-hole blow. And it does that three times, and then it's going like kind of E diminished, I guess, to E, and then it goes da 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 da, which you might be able to hear as the 2 dominant 7 to 5 dominant 7 to 1. 2 to 5, bump bump, and then it goes back down to that 1. So it's 2 to 5, and the 2 dominant 7 gives it a particular kind of feel. Anyway, what is the harp part that I'm playing? Well, this is what it is. I'm doing tongue blocked, starting on the 1/4 draw, but I'm barely hitting it. I'm jumping right up to the 3/6 blow. Can you do that? Just now, if I just do splits and I do 1/4 draw to 3/6 blow, it sounds like that. I'm blocking the lower hole of those each time of the 2 holes. So I'm really doing 4 draw. And really doing more of the 6 blow. 4, 6, 6, 5 draw. So if I do single notes, let me just try that first for you. Four draw to 6 blow. Ba 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 ba. 5 draw. Ba 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 ba. To 6 draw. Now, this is a slight adaptation of the original sax melody. There's a few more, he syncopates, the player syncopates it a little bit more than I'm syncopating it. I've kind of purified it. That's part of what the modernizing process on the harmonica is. I have a website, Modern Blues Harmonica. Part of my thing is streamline a little bit. That was the foundation of modern style. If you go back and look at the Futurists, look at Brancusi, if you're talking actual modernism, modernism, okay, in the 20s, it was streamlined. My father used to talk about how my grandfather had a car called the Chrysler Airflow. That was sort of post-World War II, and again, style, streamline, look at the way the typography gets modernized. You smooth off the serif, sans serif, right, is a sort of smooth, modern. If you go and look at the fine print when you buy a hardcover book, if you still do that, there's often a note about the typeface, and often they'll talk about how it's a streamlined modern version of some old historical typeface. So that's what we're doing here. Gussow's telling you, streamline the harp part a little bit. Can you find those notes? Again, four draw, six blow, six blow, to five draw. To six draw, you're not used to doing that little lick. Then back down to five draw. And then six blow, four draw. Now, what am I doing there? Again, that's not in the original, but that goes along with the one-man band thing I'm doing. Hey! And then I go, hey! Now we get to the release part. And by the way, so I was doing all that tongue block because I find it a little easier, but you can do it single notes. And you do that whole thing twice. Hey! So I'm going eight draw, which is the fifth. Eight draw to eight, excuse me. Yeah, eight draw to eight blow to nine blow. Fifth, major sixth, octave. And then I'm hitting that blue third on the 10-hole blow. And I'm hitting it right between major and minor. And I'm doing my own little thing, which is that I actually move the harp. I don't see other players doing that, but that for me, that works the best to get a kind of tremolo. And then I'm going to explode onto the 9-blow, which is the root or the tonic note, on the downbeat. And meanwhile, the guitar player is doing some really cool stuff behind me. Alan really is doing the original kind of stuff. Do that three times. And I'm, in order to get that da 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 da, the staccato sound, I'm using my tongue, da 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 da, on the roof of my mouth. This is all lip pursed, da 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 da, down from six draw, multiple six draws, down to the four draw. Tequila! Now I do a solo. I'm not going to talk about the solo, except to say that some of the melodic ideas on the recording are because it's an unusual change to go from the E down to the D. I'm still actually myself figuring out what works here, so I can't claim to be an expert on soloing over those particular changes. Anyway, it's hot. I need a shot of tequila, actually, but maybe a little bit of the song would be the thing that the doctor ordered. So let's see if we can order up a little bit of let's order up a shot. How about that? It's right in there. Some hand claps of the song. And if you buy it, you can play along with the harp, right? Here we go. Oh, that's right. We have that too. All right. Well, there's a lot of introductory stuff. Single notes. That's it, man. That's it. We're done. See you down the road. Bye-bye.